What's going on, guys? JS Cards here, coming at you with a Yu-Gi-Oh! Deck profile, and today we are going to go over my zombie deck. I've always liked playing zombies, and they're a really good, powerful rogue deck, and as of right now, they really aren't affected by the ban list at all, so this is pretty much like full-powered zombies, and this deck's really fun. So first off, you guys already saw it, we play three copies of Unizombie. An amazing card, you have to play this at three, along with three copies of Shiranui Solitaire. Three copies of each is standard for zombie decks. These cards are just very powerful and they help out zombie players so much. Then I play two copies of basically the boss monster, Doom King Baldurok. Baldurok is basically like a 2800 beat stick monster for the deck, but I think he's really good to play and I love the artwork. Then I play two copies of Mizuki and two copies of Gozuki. I've seen people play like three Mizuki and one Gozuki, or they mix the ratios around, but I like two of each personally. Then I play two copies of Necroworld Banshee. This card is insane. Zombie World cannot be destroyed or targeted by effects, which is insane. You can also banish Necroworld Banshee from your field or graveyard to activate Zombie World directly from your hand or deck. I play two copies of Glow Up Bloom as well because, oh my god, another amazing card. If Glow Up Bloom is sent to the graveyard, you can banish it, and then you can add one level 5 or higher zombie monster from your deck to your hand. Or if Zombie World is on the field, you can special summon it from the deck instead. Then I have one copy of Vampire Fraulein. She's pretty interesting, and she can actually be pretty good. Basically, when a zombie monster you control is attacking, you can pay life points in multiples of 100, and then during damage calculation, that monster gains that much attack. For hand traps, I play two copies of Ash and two copies of Ghost Ogre. Being tuners is also a really good advantage of these cards, and Ash being a zombie type is always good. But yeah, these hand traps are very powerful, and you gotta play some sort of hand traps. Alright, moving on to the spell cards. I play three copies of Instant Fusion, and then three copies of Super Polymerization. So yeah, we actually like to spam out of the extra deck as well. Just being able to go into like a Thousand Eyes Restrict, or go into even like a Starving Venom or anything like that. I really like having these cards, and they allow you to go into your stronger extra deck monsters. Then I play three copies of Zombie World. Oh my god, the MVP card of the deck for sure. All monsters on the field and graveyard become zombie-type monsters. Neither player can tribute summon monsters except zombie-types, which that part doesn't really matter a whole lot, but just the key sentence that it makes everything zombie-type is so insane. Three called by the grave because hand traps are annoying, so you gotta counter them some way. Two copies of Twin Twisters, just to be able to get rid of some back row. This deck can be a little weak to back row, and also the discard effect doesn't hurt you at all because you want your graveyard full. One copy of Foolish Burial and One for One. And then one card destruction. Honestly, card destruction is okay. Sometimes it's really good, sometimes you don't need it at all. But if you guys have like an extra copy of an Ash or a Ghost Ogre, or if there's anything else you want to play in replace of card destruction, you easily could. And then for trap cards, I play two. It's only two copies of Rivalry, but this is really, really good with Zombie World. Moving on to the extra deck, I play two copies of Red Eye Zombie Necro Dragon. This card's actually really good, and it can get really strong. It gains 100 attack and defense for each zombie monster on the field and in the graveyard. So a Zombie World's effect, he can actually get very powerful. Then I play one Psyframe Lord Omega. This is one of the best level 8 synchros in the game, and zombie players are very lucky to have this card. Another great level 8 to play is Beals of the Diabolic Dragons. Very powerful card. I love the artwork, and it's super easy to bring out. Love its effect as well. Then I play one Shiranui Shogun Saga and one Black Rose Dragon for the last of the Synchros. Black Rose Dragon I go into quite a bit. Shiranui not so much, but still worth playing in my opinion. Moving on to our Lynx, I play the one Vampire Sucker. Vampire Sucker is very powerful because if you're going to do a tribute summon, you can actually use your opponent's zombies instead. But you can also target one monster in your opponent's graveyard and special summon it to your opponent's side of the field, but it becomes a zombie type monster. And if a zombie monster is special summoned from either graveyard, you can draw a card. So she's got really useful effects. And then I also play Avendred Savior, another very powerful zombie Link monster. And then for other Links, I have Link Karibo, Decode Talker, just a generic Link there. Same with Underclock Taker. And then for our fusions, I have the 1000 Eyes, Starving Venom, Mud Dragon of the Swamp, and lastly, one copy of Drago Necroid Nether Soul Dragon. This deck is just really fun, and you're basically just getting out your high powered zombies and synchros and just trying to make your opponent not play Yu-Gi-Oh! With Rivalry of the Warlords and Zombie World out. So there you guys have it. That is my zombie deck profile. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe for more. Stay tuned for more Yu-Gi-Oh! News, deck profiles, and openings, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out and have a good one.